Hey guys, welcome back, and in today's video I'm gonna be showing you how to make a portrait of someone. And today we are gonna be making a portrait of Rohit Saraf. So here I have my rough sketch all done. I personally like to do it with the grid method, but you can do it with whichever way you're comfortable in. So first you need to start off with the jacket and keep the reference image by side. You need to zoom in the reference image and copy it as it is. And as always, I'll link the reference image, graded reference image, and the scanned copy of my rough sketch in the description box down below so that it would be easier for you guys to follow along. This is the base layer of the jacket where you need to mark the highlights and shadows and bring it all together. Making a portrait takes a lot of time and patience. It takes a lot of practice, so you get better as you do. The steps may differ for every portrait, but the techniques remain the same. So once you know how to do it, you can make a portrait of anyone. All you need is a good picture. Drawing the jacket seems to be very difficult, but it's actually easy. And since it's a tutorial, not a speed drawing, I'll not waste your time in showing you the same thing again and again. And your drawing need not to be perfect. To be honest, even my drawing had many flaws in it, but the thing is that the viewer may not even be able to figure it out. Even I made some mistakes throughout the video, but I did not cut or delete those clips because I wanted to keep it real with you guys. And I also wanted to let you guys know that it's okay to make mistakes, but the thing is that you should try and learn from them. That's how you'll improve as an artist. This takes a long time and I was very tired, so I took a short break, which actually turned out to be not so short. And so we have a new light setup, which is not that great. Anyways, we're gonna move on to the face. The key to draw perfect skin is the sleek shading. So basically you have to shade it really well. So I'd recommend you to first start off with the base layer, which would be the lightest, and then build it up wherever the shadows or the darker parts are. The same goes for the eyes and the lips. Now do the same with the ears too, firstly in the base layer and then build it up slowly. If you notice, the hair on the right has direct light falling on it, so they need to be done individually. Like, I have a sharpened pencil and I'm doing them very carefully so that it looks realistic. And the hair in the left is basically simple plain color. Now I'm blending the left part in because it has a block shade. Make sure to keep your pencil sharpened all the time. I use a mechanical pencil with 0.5 lead, so I don't need to sharpen it. It's the next day, so the first thing I'll do is that I'll go and fix everything up I did yesterday. When you're drawing, you might not notice the flaws, but when you come back to it later, you'll start and notice them. So that's what I'm doing and correcting them. So once I'm done with that, I'll move on to the jacket. Somebody said they saw you. The person you were kissing wasn't me, and I would never ask you. I just kept it to myself. I don't wanna know if you're playing me, keep it on the low. Now with the 10B pencil, I'm marking in the shadows. You can even use a charcoal pencil, a black color pencil, or even a normal pencil, but you'll have to apply much more pressure. Now I'm gonna do the same with charcoal pencil, which falls in the soft grade and is by Camlin. Now I'm marking in the highlights or the whiter or the lighter part with the help of a mechanical eraser, but you can even use a mono zero eraser, or you can see one of my previous videos where I show you how to make it using a normal eraser. Now I'm going in with a bold black sketch pen and applying it to the areas where it is plain black. I'm viewing the reference image on my tablet, in which I have the yellow light filter on, so make sure to switch it back to normal mode every now and then to see if the filter makes any change in your drawing, and if it does, then I'd recommend you to switch it back to normal. Now I'm going in with the acrylic paint. You can even use any other paint, but the idea here is to resemble the part where the light is falling. Now moving forward to the hand, if you observe carefully, the light is falling from the right and the left side is dark. The same goes with the hand too, but the hand is not shaded, it simply has block shades. Now the background has a certain shade, so we need to keep that in mind. Just a few strokes of pencil would do, and then I blended it out with a tissue paper as it covers a larger area. Now in the end, you just need to touch up here and there. Now I'm going in with the final layer of white paint. But this time you need to add it to the highlights in the ear or the nose as well. Now with a charcoal pencil, I'll finally finish it up. Now remove the tape and you're done. I personally liked the way it turned out, and I hope you guys enjoyed watching it too. And if you guys did, then don't forget to give it a big thumbs up and also subscribe to my channel.